So what makes the Galaxy S7 waterproof? Well, I happen to have one laying around, so let's take a look. Samsung says that the phone is IP68 water resistant. Water resistance is different than waterproof. Remember that if your phone does get damaged by water, it is not covered under the normal warranty and Samsung will not replace it. So how in the world would Samsung be able to tell if your phone has been wet in the first place? Let me show you. Up here by the SIM card tray is a water damage indicator. This little sticker with red X's on it will stay white until it comes in contact with moisture, sweat, steam, or water, and it will make the indicator bleed out and turn a pinkish color. And this indicator can be seen from outside the phone if you take out the SIM card tray and just look in. There's another water damage indicator on top of the loudspeaker. It is a smaller sticker, but if we ask if it bleeds, then yes. Yes, it does. So how does the Galaxy S7 keep water out of the device? Well, the glass panels on the front and the back do most of the work. The super sticky glue around the edges of the glass keep out the majority of the water, but there are plenty of other holes to analyze. So let's take a look at the charging port first. The charging port has its own little slot down in the bottom of the phone, and the screws keep it pressed up tight against the frame. The port itself has a little rubber seal around the edge to keep water out, but only if it is less than 1.5 meters of water, about 5 feet. Any more than that, and the weight of the water, or the water pressure, will be too great and will force itself past the rubber seal and into the phone. Apparently, the Galaxy S7 will pop a warning and won't charge if it detects water in the charging port. It does this to protect the phone, similar to how a GFCI outlet works in your bathroom, which is a good thing. It'll protect your device. Here you can see some of the super sticky residue from the tape around the back side of the phone. This keeps liquid out as well. So how does the loudspeaker stay waterproof? Air needs to reach the speaker in order for us to hear it. Samsung solved this issue by placing a small screen behind the holes for the speaker. This screen allows sound to pass through but keeps water out. The water would rather stick to itself through cohesion than be pushed through the speaker screen. But just like with the charging port, if the water pressure becomes too great, it'll force itself through the screen like grated cheese and damage your phone. The headphone jack also has a rubber seal around the opening and is glued shut along the back. The little screw also holds it firmly in place against the frame of the phone to keep water out. The power button is another weak point in the frame where there is a possibility for water to enter, but it looks like Samsung has put the same rubber seal around the inside of the button to keep water out. Up here by the SIM card tray, there is a little rubber ring around the tray itself that will seal it tight against the phone frame. Now, a few people have speculated that Samsung has made the board water resistant, which is a possibility. The technology exists, and there are companies out there that have hydrophobic, electronic safe sprays that will seal the boards, but when a PCB is covered with hydrophobic spray, any water droplets that touch the board will bead up and roll right off in little balls with zero adhesion. But as you can see from the motherboard here, the water droplet is very much adhered to the board, which proves that the board itself is not coated and is not water resistant, just the phone body. So what does this mean for the customer? I would use the Galaxy S7's water resistance as a very useful protection and safeguard against water. But I would not trust it with a daily adventure in the shower. Thanks for subscribing, and thank you for watching. All my behind-the-scenes stuff and extra tidbits of information can be found on my Twitter and my Instagram, @ZachsCherryRig. Thanks for watching.